More people are scrambling to find different New Year's Eve plans after one of the biggest holiday traditions was canceled in northern Arizona.
Holly Bach is in Flagstaff with more on why the organizer says she had to make the decision to cancel the annual pine cone drop up there. Hi, Holly.
Hi, guys. Good evening. Well, this is the time of the year a lot of people come to Flagstaff. Right now, it's not snowing. We actually did see the sun for just a little bit, but you can just see how much snow has really started to pile up right behind me. The town is so busy with visitors and just locals coming and hanging out downtown. And our first stop was here in the heart of downtown. That's because a lot of people were planning to come here on New Year's Eve. You can see the pine cone. That is what the annual pine cone drop comes down every night on New Year's Eve. But this year it is canceled once again because of COVID. The hotel owner, who's also the organizer of the event, says about 10 to 15,000 people were expected to gather as the pine cone dropped. Now, the hotel owner, Sam Green, says with the recent spread of the Omicron variant, she doesn't believe it's safe to have thousands of people shoulder to shoulder. She also tells me she is facing staffing shortages because of COVID. Now, this tradition started in 1999 and became such a staple here in Flagstaff. Green says she is hopeful the tradition can make a comeback next year, but for now, she believes canceling is the right thing to do.
We're disappointed, you know. It's big for us economically, and we're losing out. And it's big for our town and their pride. It breaks our heart, you know, to do it, but it's better to be thoughtful and think ahead till next year.
And Green says her hotel was fully booked, but she has had some cancellations. She says the decision was extra hard because, like she said, so many businesses profit off of this event every New Year's. Now, the hotel will still have their limited event. It will be a dinner with a limited menu because she is facing that staffing shortage. So there is at least that. She's hopeful that also the snow will get people out during the day. That way they can enjoy their New Year's Day at least.